Hello class 11, welcome to the online tutorial sessions for economics. Today I am going to start the third chapter in the statistics, which is collection of data, under which we are going to study about the few different terms, what is statistical inquiry and what are the sources of data. So let's start with our third chapter. Now students, what is statistical inquiry? By statistical inquiry, we mean, basically statistical inquiry means investigation on a topic. Inquiry means investigation. So investigation on a topic by any agency or by any individual, you can call it a statistical inquiry. If an individual or an agency wants to have an investigation on any topic, then that is known as statistical inquiry. Fine. Now students, there are few terms which you need to learn for this whole chapter. There are some terms which you will be having again and again, they will be repeated in your chapter so that you can learn that. Now important term which is first topic is investigator. What is investigator? The person who conducts the statistical inquiry is known as investigator. That person who just does that inquiry, who just asks the question, who wants that inquiry and who did all the work, that is the person, and that person is known as the investigator. The person who conducts the statistical inquiry is known as investigator. Now the second is enumerator. What is enumerator? The investigator needs the help of certain person to collect the information. Now the whole statistical inquiry cannot be done by the one person, so the investigator, the person who conducts this statistical inquiry, the investigator needs the help of certain people so that they can collect the information for the investigator. So those persons who are appointed to collect the information are known as enumerators. Those person who help the investigator in collecting the information, then those persons are known as enumerators. Now the third is respondents. Now who are respondents? The person from whom the statistical inquiry is collected. The persons from which or from whom the statistical inquiry is collected. Suppose I need to conduct an inquiry and I need few persons so that I can ask them the question and they can reply me back. Now in that scenario, the persons who are replying me back, who are giving me the answers, who are providing me the data, are the respondents. So students, the persons from whom the statistical inquiry is collected are known as respondents. And the last important term is survey. What is survey? Survey is a method of gathering information. There are certain methods of gathering data, certain information, then that different methods of gathering information from either individual or from the group of people, both of them includes, and the method which is known is, so the method which is used for the gathering of information is known as survey. So that's your important terms. Now let's come to the next topic, which is sources of data. Friends, let's start with the sources of data. Now these sources, there are two types of sources from which we can collect the information or from which we can collect the data. The first source is, students, internal sources. Now what are internal sources? When data is collected from the organization's own reports and records. You all know that every organization, every business organization maintains their own accounts. They maintain their own record. They have journal, they have ledger, they have balance sheets, they have so many records. So when data is collected from the organization's own reports and record, then that is known as internal source of data. Suppose the institution where I work, if I need some information and my institution provides me that information, then that is known as internal sources. The data is collected from the organization's own record and reports. then that is known as internal sources of data. Now the second source is external source. Now external source means it refers to the data collected from outside the organization. The data which is collected from outside the organization is known as external source. Is that clear? So the difference between internal source and external source: in the internal sources we collect the data from organization's own record and reports, but in external sources we go outside the organization to collect the data. Now students, external sources are further categorized into two more sources, which is primary data and secondary data. Now students, let's start with the primary data. What are primary data? The data which are originally collected by an investigator or agency for the first time for some specific purpose. Now let's decode it. Data which is originally collected by an investigator. Suppose I need some data and I myself go to the area, I go to the investigation area, and by myself I collect all the data. I meet all the people, I meet all the persons who have witnessed, and I personally meet them and collect my data. I collect my information by myself or by the agency for the first time. Nobody has before collected that information. We are the first. I am the first. The agency is the first one who has collected the data, that is the original data, for some specific purpose. There must be a reason, there must be a purpose for collecting that data. So these data are known as primary data. Now the source from which the primary data is collected is known as primary source. Those investigation area or those people from which I am collecting the data are known as primary sources. The source from which the primary data is collected is known as primary source. Now for example, population of census population, which you all know, which happens in India after every 10 years, that population census is conducted by the government of India. Under this scenario, each and every member is met by the government official, and each and every information of the required information is being given by that person face to face. So that is the first hand information, and those are the primary sources. Now the primary data, it takes a longer period of time because you have to go by yourself, you have to meet them by yourself. You are the one who is doing that inquiry for the first time. Nobody has ever done that, so it will take time. That's why it takes longer period of time. Now because you have done it by yourself, it is more reliable. You haven't asked someone else to do that work for you, so it is more reliable. Now because you are the one who is searching for the data, then that is why it is costly too, because you have to go to those places again and again and again, and you have to visit different places. Then in that scenario it becomes very costly too. So this is the primary data. So what is primary data? Primary data is originally collected by an investigator or agency for the first time for some specific purpose. Now these sources from which the primary data is collected is known as primary source. Now for example, population census is conducted by the government of India. It takes longer period of time, it is more reliable, and it is costly. Now let's come to the next one, which is secondary data. Now students, let's start with the secondary data. That is the last topic for this video. So secondary data, the data which is not directly collected. Keyword: data which is not directly collected by an investigator, but instead of obtained from the published or unpublished sources. Now what are other published and unpublished sources? The persons who have already done a statistical inquiry on that पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक और ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर इशू और एनी अदर पर्पस विच इज द सेम एज योर्स, देन इन दैट केस यू आर गोइंग टू मीट देम टू दैट एजेंसी और टू दैट पर्सन. Whether he has published his report publicly or he has not published that report, you are going to take help from that person or that agency, or you are going to ask to offer his report to you. Now in that case, it is not directly collected by the investigator, but it is rather obtained from someone else who has already done that inquiry. Now, it is also known as second-hand inquiry because this inquiry is not done by you. It is done by someone else, some other agency or some other individual. That's why it is known as second-hand data. For example, National Account Statistics published by CSO. The National Account Statistics, which publishes the data about the accounts and economy, which is published by the CSO, and this CSO gives the information to the government of India. So the government of India takes the second-hand information from CSO, which is published by the National Account Statistics. Fine. Now, the secondary data, it takes shorter time period because you just have to go to the concerned person who has already the inquiry, that statistical inquiry. You just have to meet them and you can have the entire data. It is less reliable. Why? Because it's not done by you. It is done by someone else and you don't trust them. It takes lots of trust so that becomes reliable for you. But still, if it's not done by you, it is not as much as reliable as primary data is. So it is not reliable. It is less reliable. And if you compare with the primary data, it is cheaper also because you don't have to travel much places. That work has already been done by someone else. That is why it is called the second-hand data. So it is cheaper if you say in comparison to the primary data. So students, you all have covered the important topics. You know what is statistical inquiry. You know what are the different sources of data. You know what is internal sources. You know what is external sources. And you know the bifurcation of the primary data and secondary data. What are primary data and what is secondary data. You have the examples. You have the characteristics. So students, I want you all to take a clear screenshot so that you can complete your notes. Students, go for the screenshot, take a very neat and clean screenshot. Pause this video and take a screenshot. Fine. I hope you all have taken the screenshot. Now, students, that's all for this video. See you soon.